I welcome you all to the screening of the short film, The Icon and the Iconoclast at the Being Human Festival, which is the UK's only national festival of the humanities. Led by the School of Advanced Study, the University of London, in partnership with the Arts and Humanities Research Council and the British Academy. The Being Human Festival seeks to bring the best of humanities research in the UK to the public. My thanks to Being Human Festival for providing a platform for screening this film, and also to Meena Dhanda, Professor of Philosophy and Cultural Politics at the University of Wolverhampton, for organizing the series Riches, Resurgence in Commemoration, Humor, Exchange, and Storytelling, and inviting us to present this film as a part of that series. This short is a docudrama based on a conversation between Mahatma Gandhi and Periyar E.V. Ramasamy that reportedly happened in the year 1927. The film is directed by Vilasini Ramani. The film stars Kishore as Periyar, Salmin Sheriff as Gandhi, and Swami as S. Ramanathan. Kishore is a widely acclaimed actor in the Indian film industry. He is most known for his collaborations with the award-winning director Vetrimaran, Paranjit, and he will be playing a key role in Maniratnam's upcoming historical epic, Ponniyin Selvan. Kanti, Polladavan, Vennila Kabadikudu, Adukalam, Haridas, Visaranai, Vadachennai are some of the many films where his performance was greatly lauded. Salmin Sheriff is a playwright who has been involved in theater for over 25 years and is a founding member of the theatre group Playpen. A well-known and much celebrated artist in Bengaluru, Salmin Sheriff has also acted in films most notably Nirmal Anand Ki Puppy and The Sky is Pink. Swami is a theatre artist based in Chennai who has acted in the plays of the renowned playwright Indira Parthasarathy, and The Icon and the Iconoclast is his film debut. This is the second film for the director Vilasini, who is also a freelance publisher and translator. Her first film, No Means No, which is a part of a trilogy titled Are You Divorced Yet, is currently in post-production. I thank you all and your entire film crew for coming together and bringing these towering historical personalities alive and for presenting to us a highly interesting conversation that offers us a privileged view of debates of concern roughly a century before. Indeed, issues concerning religion continue to be relevant even today, perhaps more sensitive today than earlier. It is thus of both intellectual and artistic interest to revisit this conversation between the Mahatma and Periyar, the icon and the iconoclast. It was an honor for me to be a project consultant for this amazing film. Several friends and well-wishers have contributed in many ways to the making of this film, and I thank you all. To briefly introduce myself, I am Marie Curie Research Fellow at the University of Wolverhampton, working on the project Freedom from Caste, the Political Thought of Periyar E.V. Ramasamy in a Global Context. As the title suggests, this research is an attempt to take the political thoughts of Periyar to a broader global audience. And I see my involvement as a project consultant in this film as a step in that direction. For more information on my research, do follow the website, theperiyarproject.com. Many in the audience are no doubt much familiar with the concept of caste, but let me just provide a very brief outline here for those who are not familiar. The traditional classification of Indian Hindu society is the hierarchical Varna model, wherein the Brahmins, the priests come learned, the Kshatriyas, the warriors, the Vaishyas, the businessmen, and the Shudras, the laborers and artisans, are supposed to have evolved respectively from the head, arms, thighs, and feet of the primordial being. Those who followed of this fourfold system were the untouchables, whom we call Dalits today. The social reality of India, however, is that of Jati, or caste. There are thousands of caste groups across India, and caste grouping in many parts of the country greatly influences one's social, cultural, economic, and political activities, as well as privileges or absence of the same. The fundamental aspect of caste is hierarchical difference based on birth in a specific caste group. Several social reformers, both religious and secular, have attempted over the ages to challenge, reform, or completely eradicate caste. In the study of caste in modern India, the names of the characters whom we are going to see on screen today are unavoidable. Now, about the film, let me briefly introduce our characters. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, of course, needs no introduction, even to a global audience. A key leader of the Indian National Movement, he is widely known for his thoughts on nonviolent resistance. An inspiration for leaders like Martin Luther King Jr. and Nelson Mandela, Gandhi's legacy, however, is being reevaluated by anti-racist and anti-caste scholars. In his own time, Mahatma Gandhi's views on caste and religion were challenged by Indian anti-caste leaders. While Ambedkar's critical approach to Gandhi and Gandhiism is widely known in India, another leader who was critical of Gandhi's political and social views was Periyar E.V. Ramasamy, popularly known as Periyar. Periyar is seen by his supporters in South India as a rationalist, the key figure of the Dravidian self-respect movement, an anti-caste campaigner, a champion of the social and political rights of the subaltern caste, a proto-feminist, and a fighter for greater autonomy for Tamil Nadu. He is, however, most popularly known for his atheism and controversially for his acerbic attacks on the Hindu religion and the Hindu gods. Many of the views of Periyar have elicited much extreme reactions, especially from those on the Hindu right, who view him as anti-Hindu, anti-Brahmin, and by virtue of that, anti-national. Periyar was indeed critical of Hinduism, Brahmin privilege, and nationalism. But he was also equally critical of religion in general, caste and casteism in general, and of any thought that denigrated or denied the dignity and the sovereignty of the individual human being. Periyar's statues across the state of Tamil Nadu bear the inscriptions, "There is no God. He who created God is a fool. He who propagates God is a scoundrel. He who worships God is a barbarian." While being a convinced atheist, Periyar's atheism was not rooted in a mere rejection of religion, but in an overall concern for social justice and equality. The British Marxist Perry Anderson called Periyar a fearless enemy of caste and sexual inequality. Dravidian, Dalit, and feminist supporters of Periyar view his critique of religion as an integral aspect of his egalitarian thought. Now, Periyar started his political career as a Congress supporter in 1920. He was initially attracted to Gandhian ideas, and he greatly worked to promote the same in Tamil Nadu. Though Periyar joined the Congress, he was aware and critical of the overrepresentation of upper caste in its leadership. He tried to make the Congress in Tamil Nadu not just a mass movement, but also a party that had representation from several layers of the non-Brahmin caste. At that point of time, the Congress was overwhelmingly dominated by the Brahmin caste. Likewise, despite constituting only 3% of the population, the Brahmins were also overrepresented in education and in the bureaucracy. When Periyar felt that the Congress was not receptive to his proposals for taking a more proactive position on social reform and the inclusion of non-Brahmins in general and marginalized castes specifically, he broke away from the Congress party. Periyar, along with S. Ramanathan, were the key figures who launched the self-respect movement in the mid-1920s, to secure political and social empowerment of non-Brahmins, and also to challenge the social and political domination of the Brahmin caste and other upper castes. S. Ramanathan, who had strong socialist sympathies, was a co-traveler with Periyar when the latter visited the Soviet Union and met progressive leaders and organizations in Europe. Though he left the Congress, Periyar had a high regard for Mahatma Gandhi and continued to support his non-cooperation movement. Periyar met Gandhi in Bangalore in 1927. He sensed Gandhi's reluctance to take casteism and the domination of elite castes in positions of power in the Congress head-on. Periyar broke away from his commitment to Gandhian ideals and began viewing the Mahatma as an obstacle to social reform and revolution. Further, Periyar's break from Gandhi became sharper over the issue of separate electorates for the depressed classes, who are now called Dalits. Dr. Ambedkar, the highly erudite Dalit leader and intellectual, was a strong advocate for this cause, while Gandhi opposed it. Periyar stood firmly by Ambedkar and spoke out vocally supporting him and criticizing Gandhi. However, when Gandhi was assassinated in 1948, Periyar praised Gandhi for his services to India and suggested that India be renamed as Gandhi Nadu. Like many of his other positions, Periyar's opinions on Gandhi evolved continuously. With respect to caste and religion, he was sharply critical of Gandhi, even after Gandhi's demise. But he also said in other occasions that it was because Gandhi was re-evaluating his own approach to caste and religion that he was assassinated by a Hindu nationalist Brahmin. You can see almost all of these positions of Periyar on Gandhi reflected in this conversation in this film that reportedly happened in 1927. I consciously say reportedly here. I got this conversation from the volumes of the Periyar Collegium, which is the most extensive collection of the writings and speeches of Periyar, and which is the primary source for my research. It is mentioned that this conversation was first published in 1927 in Periyar's party paper, Kudiyarasu. While the Gandhi-Periyar meeting definitely happened, the content of the conversation appears only in Periyar-related sources, so one might question whether it is a verbatim reproduction of the Gandhi-Periyar conversation. When I consulted with veteran Tamil historians, I was told, firstly, that the conversation is a near accurate representation of the positions of these two leaders at that point of time. Secondly, though this conversation was well circulated over the ages, Gandhian scholars have not contested its veracity. Again, I do not take this as a foolproof evidence that this conversation happened as it has been recorded. So I look forward to historians to challenge and even refute the same, and I really look forward to learning from them. But I do think that this interaction throws good light on the approaches of these two leaders to caste and religion. Most importantly, it shows how these thinkers with significantly different views on religion could nevertheless have a respectful dialogue with each other. Issues of religion involve difficult conversations, but they also need these difficult conversations. Of course, Periyar is greatly attractive to atheists and anti-castists in India. But what about believers? To those who feel that their religion and caste is threatened, the views of Periyar might appear offensive and blasphemous. To those who are firm of faith, but are open to alternative viewpoints, they might find something humorous and perhaps even something to reflect on in this conversation between Periyar and Gandhi. The lead character of Umberto Eco's The Name of the Rose says that the mission of those who love humanity is to make people laugh at divinely held truths. I hope our viewers today can laugh and learn from the icon and the iconoclast. I thank you all again for being here. Now, let me hand over the place to Professor Meena Dhanda, who will say a few words about the event, and we'll start the screening of the film. Thank you all.
Thank you, Karthick, for that wonderfully thoughtful introduction to what we are going to witness today. I will not stand too long between the film and the audience who's eagerly waiting to watch. I want to welcome all of you, Vilasini, the director, and Salmin, and Kishore, and Swaminathan, who are meeting for the first time. It's marvelous to have you all here. On behalf of the Being Human Festival, I simply want to say a couple of words to the audience who are participating. So the Being Human Festival, as Karthick said, is a festival of humanities. It is an attempt on the part of humanities academics to share with the public their research. Often we take for granted that the sciences have something useful to do, but not so the humanities. And this festival, which has run for many years, and the University of Wolverhampton has participated in for many years as well, is our attempt to share our research with the wider world. Now, it's really important in order to keep this festival free of cost and publicly funded that we give our feedback on it. So in the chat, I have added the survey link, the smartsurveyco.uk Being Human 2021 audience. I would ask you all at the end of today's event to take 5 minutes to please complete that survey. The survey is wholly anonymous. You're free to say whatever you like, and it will be used to develop future events. Since our film, the one that Karthik was consulted on and the one that Vilasini has directed and people present here have participated in, is coming out of our EU project in which Karthik is a Marie Curie fellow and I am supervising. So it's very important for our project too that we get your feedback. And as Karthik has already said, we have to see it in the spirit in which it is made. It is a purpose is to make people think about certain issues. So we do want to say, we hope that the way it's presented does not offend anyone. It's likely that it might offend some people, but this is a part of an attempt to keep the space for open dialogue open. We really want that more and more people should be able to join and think without fear about some really difficult questions. And here we've got two really important people who are going to engage in a conversation. And in that conversation itself, there is a lesson about how to have conversations. So I hope you enjoy the film, and I'll take it back to Karthik. Thank you all for being here with us today.
Okay. Elena, can we stop the recording? I'll start sharing the film now.